In this video, we're looking at a heavy disk with a given mass of 2.5 kilograms, a given radius of 15 centimeters, and this disk is accelerated by a motor to a known final angular velocity of 500 RPMs, and that process takes 5 seconds. In part A, we're going to compute the average torque exerted by the motor, and in part B, the average power output of that motor. So to prepare for part A, we want to convert that 500 RPMs into SI units. We want radians per second for that. So RPMs means rotations per minute. We need to convert the rotations to radians. And there are 2π radians in a rotation. The units of rotations cancel there. And then we need to convert the minutes into seconds. And of course, there are 60 seconds in a minute. This gives us 52.4 radians per second. Now the strategy for part A is that I want to get the average angular acceleration for the disk. I know it started from rest, I know the final angular velocity is 52.4 radians per second, and I know how long it took for the acceleration process to occur. So that rate of change in the angular velocity, that's the angular acceleration that I'm looking for. And then we'll relate that to torque with the rotational equivalent of Newton's second law. So first the angular acceleration, and this is an average value just because we're not guaranteed the acceleration rate was constant throughout the process. What we know is the initial and final angular velocities. That gives us the change in angular velocity. If we divide that by the change in time, we've got the average angular acceleration. Now, my initial angular velocity was 0, so delta omega, the change in angular velocity, is just the final value because the initial value was 0. And then delta t is 5 seconds. And this gives us 10.5 radians per second squared on average. Next, we need to get the moment of inertia for this disk. And the formula for moment of inertia of a disk is 1/2 mr squared. We plug in the mass, that's 2.5 kilograms, the radius squared, making sure that we convert that to meters, so 0.15 squared. And this gives us 0.0281 kilogram meters squared. Now again, the point of all this prep work is that we're going to plug into the rotational equivalent of Newton's second law, that's tau equals I alpha. The torque is the analog for force, moment of inertia is the analog for mass, angular acceleration is the analog for acceleration. So this is really just a rotational version of F equals ma. And because we're talking about values that are averaged over a finite period of time, these are averages, average torque and average angular acceleration. And that average torque is just given by the moment of inertia, 0.0281, times our average angular acceleration, 10.5 radians per second squared. And this gives us a value of 0.295 newton meters. Next, we want the average power output of the motor. So all we're doing here is looking at how much energy ended up in the disk, how long did it take to get there, and then the rate of energy transfer is what we mean by power. So we're going to compute the rotational kinetic energy of the disk in its final state. I'll call that K final, and that's 1/2 I omega squared. Again, all these formulas are analogous to those for linear motion. Moment of inertia is playing the role of mass here. Angular velocity, omega, is playing the role of velocity. So this is the analog to 1/2 mv squared. We plug in the moment of inertia that we already computed, 0.0281. We plug in the final angular velocity, that's 52.4 radians per second, and we have to square that. And this gives us a rotational kinetic energy of 38.6 joules. Now the initial kinetic energy was 0 because the disk started from rest. And so our average power output is just the total energy that ended up in the disk divided by how long it took to get there. So we could call that a change in energy divided by change in time. Sometimes that's written as a work divided by time, and that's 38.6 joules divided by the 5 seconds that it took to transfer to the disk. And this gives us an average power output of 7.72 watts. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.